heard of lithium-ion batteries, the most common type of rechargeable batteries that power our smartphones, laptops, electric cars, and even some grid-scale energy storage systems. But did you know that there is a new type of battery that could potentially replace lithium-ion batteries for good? That's right, I'm talking about redox flow batteries, or RFBs for short. These are a different kind of rechargeable batteries that use liquid electrolytes to store and release energy. They have some amazing advantages over lithium-ion batteries, such as longer lifespan, lower cost, higher safety, and more flexibility. In this video, we will explain how redox flow batteries work, what are their current applications and challenges, and how a recent breakthrough by a team of researchers could revolutionize the field of energy storage and make redox flow batteries the dominant technology in the future. So buckle up and get ready for an electrifying ride. And this is redox flow breakthroughs that will replace lithium for good. So, how do redox flow batteries work? Well, unlike lithium-ion batteries, which have solid electrodes and a liquid electrolyte, redox flow batteries have liquid electrodes and a liquid electrolyte. The electrodes are stored in separate tanks and pumped through a cell stack, where they undergo chemical reactions to store or release energy. The electrolyte is a solution that contains dissolved ions that carry the electric charge. The key to redox flow batteries is the redox reaction, which stands for reduction oxidation reaction. This is a type of chemical reaction where electrons are transferred between molecules. In a redox flow battery, one electrode is oxidized, meaning it loses electrons, and the other electrode is reduced, meaning it gains electrons. This creates an electric current that can power devices or be stored in the battery. There are different types of redox flow batteries, depending on the materials used for the electrodes and the electrolyte. The most common ones are vanadium redox flow batteries, which use vanadium ions in different oxidation states as the electrodes. Vanadium is a metal that can exist in four different oxidation states, meaning it can easily switch between losing and gaining electrons. Vanadium redox flow batteries have the advantage of using the same material for both electrodes, which reduces the risk of cross-contamination and improves the stability and efficiency of the battery. Vanadium redox flow batteries are already being used for large-scale energy storage applications, such as grid stabilization, renewable energy integration, and peak shaving. They can store large amounts of energy for long periods of time and can be easily scaled up or down by changing the size of the tanks or the concentration of the electrolyte. They also have a long lifespan, up to 20 years or more, and can withstand thousands of charge-discharge cycles without losing capacity. For example, this is a 4 MWh vanadium redox flow battery system that was installed in China in 2016. It is connected to a wind farm and provides backup power and frequency regulation to the grid. It can store enough energy to power about 400 homes for an hour. So, if redox flow batteries are so great, why are they not more widely used? Well, one of the main challenges is the cost. Redox flow batteries are still more expensive than lithium-ion batteries, mainly due to the high cost of the materials and the complexity of the system. Vanadium, for example, is a rare and expensive metal that accounts for about 40% of the total cost of a vanadium redox flow battery. Another challenge is the performance. Redox flow batteries have lower energy density and power density than lithium-ion batteries, meaning they can store less energy and deliver less power per unit volume or mass. This makes them less suitable for applications that require high power output or compact size, such as electric vehicles or portable devices. Moreover, redox flow batteries have some technical issues that need to be solved, such as electrolyte degradation, membrane fouling, shunt currents, and leakage. These can affect the efficiency, safety, and reliability of the battery. So, how can we overcome these challenges and make redox flow batteries more competitive and attractive? The researchers have developed a new type of redox flow battery that uses organic molecules instead of metal ions as the electrodes. These organic molecules are derived from natural sources, such as plants or bacteria, and are cheaper, safer, and more environmentally friendly than metals. The researchers have also designed a new electrolyte that is water-based instead of acid-based. This reduces the corrosion and toxicity of the battery and allows for higher concentrations and voltages. The result is an aqueous organic redox flow battery that has a record performance and stability. It has an energy density of 70 watt-hours per liter, which is twice as high as conventional redox flow batteries. It also has a power density of 200 milliwatts per square centimeter, which is 4 times higher than conventional redox flow batteries. And it can last for over 10,000 cycles without losing capacity or efficiency. The researchers have demonstrated their prototype battery in a lab-scale system that can power a LED light bulb. They claim that their battery can be scaled up to megawatt-hour levels and be used for grid-scale energy storage applications. So, there you have it. A new type of redox flow battery that could potentially replace lithium-ion batteries for good. This is a huge breakthrough that could have a significant impact on the future of energy storage and renewable energy. It could also open up new possibilities for other applications that require low-cost, long-lasting, and safe batteries. Of course, this is still a proof of concept, and there are still many challenges and questions to be answered before this technology can be commercialized and widely adopted. But the researchers are optimistic and confident that their battery can be further improved and scaled up in the near future. If you want to learn more about this breakthrough, you can check out their research paper in the journal Nature Energy. The link is in the description below. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. And don't forget to share your thoughts and questions in the comments section below. We love to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, stay curious and stay tuned.